this lesson is of post-war world and India. So, post-world war is for after World War II, what is the position of India? What is the result of World War? So, after World War II, so many changes are coming in the world. Same way, India also got so many changes. So, we have to see first about the world situation after World War II. So, after war means consequences of World War II. What are the consequences of World War II? There are crores of people died in the World War II. Crores, hundreds of crores of people died and millions of crores of rupees wasted for years. So, First World War started in 1949-1980. World War II started in 1939 and it is ended in 45. So, 6 years nearly fought World War. Due to that, lot of time wasted, lot of money, lot of people died, lot of people got injuries. They lost unemployment. So, production also they lost. So, due to that, so many problems faced. The warring countries' main contenders are Britain one side and Germany group one side. Though Germany was responsible to World War II, they lost in the World War. So they also got so many losses, and their associate countries also losses they got. Same way, Britain is the winner group. They also spent lot of money, lot of time wasted. So there is no happy. Britain lost its time, money, and unemployment problem. Industries also collapsed. People also, nobody is unhappy. Because lot of wastage is there. And all over the world, so many countries due to this World War II facing so many crises, economic crises, social problems. And production also not there. And employment also, they lost imports, export also, they got losses. So due to this, nobody bought now wars. So though it is ended in 1945, Britain was also unhappy. It has to lose its colonies. After that time, Britain was a dominant country in the world. But after World War II, there is no happy as a winner of company. So many countries revolted against Britain for independent purpose. India was also protesting against Britain for independence. India, Pakistan, like Myanmar, and Sri Lanka, like others, China, and African countries also protesting and revolting against Britain. So it has to lose colonies. Same way, financial losses also taken place. So then, who were the gainers in the World War II? If only one country, America, USA, got the benefit. Though it is participated at the end of the World War II, they were very less, they got damages. Due to war, America got so much benefit by way of business, selling their goods and selling their weapons, and unemployment not lost this. Because America not participated directly, and war was fought in European countries only. America only at end they helped by way of weapons and only limited participation there. But due to that, result was very nice. That was the better. So America is better position. Even Russia, US, then it was called USSR. Russia got a lot of losses. Poland got, and Yugoslavia, the neighboring countries they got. So devastating situation was there. But still, Russia after World War II, they gained much. Industrially they developed more. They implemented their schemes, projects, employment improved. And America and Russia became the superpowers after World War II. And up to that World War II, Britain was the leading country, dominating country in the world. So it has become the third country. So after World War II, so many countries changed. So many new countries emerged as independent countries. So many countries got So due to this, what is happening? There is a Cold War situation developed. Cold War. World War situation developed. So, World War II, when it is going to end, there was an organization started, that is United Nations Organization. First World War after 1920, League of Nations was established. What was the purpose of League of Nations establishment? So, it is to stop wars and maintain peace and help for the development of the world, particularly backward countries to be developed. But it is unable to fail again, World War II started. So, some countries not supported or not cooperated with the League of Nations. So, but this idea was again came forward during the time of World War II, then due to initiative of America and Britain and other countries like China, France, USSR supported for formation of NWO. 1945, when World War II ended, then UNO was formed. So, UNO was formed and 51 countries taken membership first. So, UNO was established in New York, America headquarters there. So, it formed 6 organs for developmental activities taking up like UNESCO, UNICEF, ILO, and International Court of Justice, other organs also, branches also established by UNO. So, first, what was the main purpose of UNO? What is the objective? Is stop the war, maintain the world peace, and help the development of humanitarianism and develop the democratic attitudes like improvement of fundamental rights, individual rights, individual freedoms to be here, and countries maintain democratic rights. So, UNO don't want to interfere in the affairs of any internal matters, except there is a damage to the fundamental rights or not maintaining democratic rights, then only they have to intervene and set aside the dispute or problem in a peaceful manner. So, main idea behind this UNO was to maintain world peace, control the wars, and help the developmental activities. And children's and women's also they give a preference for. As regards to women, they established a Women's Rights Commissioner, Children's Purpose also Children's Rights Commission, and Civil Rights Commission also established in the world. So, then onwards they are helping in so many ways. This is the point kind of achievement, great achievement to UNO. But major idea behind the stopping of wars was not fulfilled 100%. Because some wars taken place in some countries, members countries. But that was not led to any one war. So this is the major. So now, last point, two countries, USA and USSR, they became the two superpowers in the world. So, they are attracting the countries towards democracy, towards communism. So, democracy countries, America, USA. USA, capitalist country, it is supporting democracy, multi-party system. China. So, USA and USSR, they formed camps. That means they are attracting countries towards their group. So, USA want democratic countries to be improved in the world so that it will become the superpower. So, USSR want to establish socialist governments so that they will become the superpowers in the countries. So, this is the Cold War situation. They are polarizing between the countries. They are helping the countries to bring to their fold. Because USA and US are dead against. US supports capitalism and socialism supports labor's domination, working class domination, group domination, single party system is there. So, USA and USSR are helping these backward countries and newly independent countries in way of financial assistance and technical knowledge also they are supplying, imports, imports and exports business is carrying out between them, friendly rich and they are with you. So, very well, situation is there, they are supporting. So, one is encouraging, one is discouraging. Like this, World War, a Cold War position is going on in the world. This is the consequence of World War. Okay? Thus, this is Rajalingo, social teacher from Malini Valmiki Schools.